through this far with the rain. Good news, it's clearing on out.
Yeah, steaming on up out there too, isn't it?
Big day of the week, though, is tomorrow before the steaminess comes back into town. So if you've got the day off tomorrow, if you're doing something outside, pick tomorrow. All right, back outside for you right now. Let me show you what it looks like across Central Florida at this hour. Oh, look at that sky. When I came in, we had building Q. We had some rain around. Not anymore. We've cleared out. Good looking shot right there. Let's go right to the satellite radar and show you what it looks like at this hour. Most of the energy right now is right here, passing through eastern Volusia County, eastern Brevard County, although one low shower still kind of hanging on there on the northeast side of downtown Ocala. There's the 301. All this energy kind of passing off towards the east northeast. If it holds together, Cedar Creek, you may have yourself a quick parting shower before it's all said and done. Here's Palm Coast, Belterre Parkway. We had a few showers falling apart on approach to Flagler Beach. Good news there. As we head into Daytona Beach, Port Orange, and Ponce Inlet, this one's kind of holding together, so a little heavier shower en route to Ponce Inlet and over towards Port Orange. We'll keep an eye on it. No thunder, no lightning, just a good old downpour there for you over the next half hour. There's Titusville, another little line of a few passing showers right along I-95. We already had one accident due to the weather there, so we'll keep tabs of this one there for you. Over towards downtown Orlando, things are fairly quiet. Dave McDaniel down right about there. One shower to the south of him. That should stay to the south. That'll keep the fans on the happy side. All right, afternoon temperatures right now, upper 70s to near the 80-degree mark. Winds now pulling around to the northwest. That's a drier, a more comfortable pattern for us. And you're going to see overnight low temperatures tonight by 11 o'clock, falling back into the mid-60s, comfortable humidity levels. And tomorrow, downright, absolutely picture-perfect. Get out there and enjoy it. Daybreak temperatures running in the mid to the upper 50s across most of central Florida. South of the 408, temperatures will hold in the low 60s. We take a look now at that forecast tonight through tomorrow morning. High pressure builds on in, just enough of a breeze that we're not worried about any fog. Thursday afternoon, glorious day. We're on the west side of high pressure, but as high pressure begins to pull to the east as we head into the weekend, those temperatures will go up, up, and away. High temperatures tomorrow look like this. Ocala, 84. Bellevue coming in, 84 degrees. Bushnell, 85. Beautiful Mount Dora and Eustis, 84 degrees. Over towards Oviedo, Winter Springs, Altamont Springs running close to about 84 degrees. Downtown Orlando, over towards Kissimmee, St. Cloud. Your afternoon high temperatures here, 83, 84 degrees. Can't forget our friends in Lakeland, Winter Haven, closer to about 85 degrees. That does include you, Davenport. Palm Bay, over towards Melbourne, Merritt Island, Titusville and Cocoa, low 80s, a pretty good call here. As you work your way up the Palm Coast, we'll hold in the upper 70s, the land coming in at about 82 degrees. Having said that, then let's take a look now at the Taste of College Park. Again, at Dubstred, Jason Brew is going to be hosting this. Come on out, spend a few bucks, and raise a little bit of money for the good folks over there in College Park. All right, 7-day outlook looks like this. Up, up, and away, still nearing the upper 80s to 90 degrees. We're not going to put a 90 in just yet, but Jim and Martha, you know it's right around the corner.